Hello everyone. Welcome to the 10th video of the Adobe After Effects tutorial from beginner to advanced. In the previous tutorial, you learned how to create keyframes. In this video, we examine the types of keyframes and the concept of easy ease. For this tutorial, I will first create a composition and change its color. I consider the duration of the composition to be 5 seconds. I create 4 circles with the Shapes tool and choose different colors for them to differentiate from each other. A layer is created for each circle in the timeline. In future lessons, I will teach how to create shapes. I select all 4 layers and press the letter P on the keyboard to reveal the position option for all 4 layers. I set the time indicator to frame 0 and click on the stopwatch to create a keyframe for each layer. Because I selected all 4 layers, when I click on one of the stopwatches, a keyframe will be created in front of each layer. Now I put the time indicator at 2 seconds. And by changing the position value of one of the layers, I move all the shapes to the front. In this way, another keyframe is created in 2 seconds for each layer, and you can see the coordinated movement of the shapes. Now I want these shapes to return to their previous position in the second 4. So, I set the time indicator at 4 seconds, and copy and paste each of my keys at 4 seconds. I copy with Ctrl plus C and Ctrl plus V buttons as I taught in previous lessons. If I press the play button from the preview panel, we can see that the shapes move in harmony and at a constant speed. All of these keyframes that are created are in linear mode by default, which makes the speed of movement of an object remain the same from the beginning to the end of the path. In fact, the closer these keyframes are to each other, the faster the object moves. Now let's change the type of keyframes of the second circle. So I select the keyframes of this layer and right-click on one of the selected keyframes. Next, in the Keyframe Assistant section, there are Easy Ease options. The first option is Easy Ease, which you can activate with the F9 button. After selecting this option, the shape of the keyframe will change. This type of keyframe creates natural and smooth movement along the path. In fact, when you create this type of keyframe for an object, the movement of the object slowly reaches its peak speed and slowly stops at the end of the path. Now I select the frames of the third figure and right-click. This time, I choose the Easy Ease in option, which you can activate with the F9 plus Shift button. Again, after selecting this option, the shape of the keyframes will change. In this type of keyframe, the object immediately reaches its maximum speed, but at the end, the path stops slowly. This time I select the keyframes of the fourth circle and right-click. I choose the Easy Ease Out option, which you can activate with the F9 plus Shift plus Control button. By choosing this option, you can see that the shape of the keyframes changes. In this type of keyframe, at the beginning of the path, the movement of the object is slow and smooth, and at the end of the path, it stops at the highest speed and suddenly. Now you can see the difference between the types of keyframes and their effect on the speed of objects. There is another type of keyframe called toggle hold keyframe, which causes the object to jump from one keyframe to the next keyframe. In order to better understand this issue, I will delete the keyframes of the first circle and create new keyframes. Now select all the keyframes and right-click on one of them, and select Toggle Hold Keyframe. The shape of the keyframes changes again, and I press the play button. You can see that our shape jumps on each keyframe, and we no longer see the object moving between keyframes. At the end of this tutorial, remember 3 points. First, by selecting one or more keyframes and right-clicking on one of them, we can change the color of the keyframes from the label section, so that we can find the desired keyframe more easily later. Second, to snap the time indicator on the keyframes, you can hold the shift button at the same time. And the last point is that by selecting each layer, you can see the movement direction of that layer in the composition panel. Of course, in future lessons, I will teach you how to edit the speed and direction of the object with the help of handles. Be sure to practice all these things to learn how to work with different types of keyframes well. Please like the video and leave a comment for me. Subscribe to see more tutorials. I'll see you next time.